So yeah, I'm going to pass you over to Guillermo, who's going to be talking about Android Slices. So can you welcome him? Big round of applause.
There was a technical issue, so this talk was meant to be delivered by two people, but Anna couldn't make it, so I'm on my own, and I have a demo. So let's hope that my sacrifice to the demo gods went through, and everything is gonna go all right. So this is slicing up slices, because Anna loves putting titles that make my tongue twist. And let's start. Yeah, let's get started. So, or
maybe not.
Okay. That's it. Google 2018. If someone doesn't know what it is, it's basically a really nice excuse to get to know shiny new stuff and get all really excited. Leading-edge APIs with the corresponding state of ways to get your POs really, really, really well excited and get their attention. So you can get them, look at this, you can get this much retention, or I don't know, whatever other metrics they like. And I went to Google I/O, I had a blast, and when I came back, I was like, oh, this thing that we should try, we should really try, which is Slices. You may be asking, why? Well, let's take a step back. I think what there was before Slices. I want a quick show of hands. How many of you have coded a widget in Android before? Quite a few. I'm sorry. How many of you enjoy coding a widget? Exactly. So, why? So, this is how widgets looked at the beginning, and it's all coming back to remote views. What is a remote views? We can see here two really shiny new examples of remote views, which is those widgets, but also those notifications are remote views. They are just ways that they had to display content from other apps. They have been displayed in a different process, because obviously your widget is not the same process like your application. They have been there since API level 1, that's why I took those really nice screenshots, just to make my point. And, well, they were baked in the OS, so you could upgrade it somewhat, but, well, if you made a bad decision, you would stick with it forever. And for some strange reason, the internet parsable, because why not? Sure, long story short, we just need to provide a remote use services, and that needs to be created by a remote use factory, that updated by app widget provider, and making it app widget manager. What the? I had to read it. There's no way I could remember that. Like, yeah, and so when you were trying to use a widget, you felt a bit like, yeah. So back to Slices. So now you understand why I was so excited about this. So what's a slice, really? So you may guess by now what is a slice. So it's a UI template, so it's something more generic. It just puts content of an app inside others, like also more generic. And it's basically what a remote view would be like if you coded them today. It's a really fine job. What should a slice be? So according to Google, the content of slice should be interactive. So just not like, I don't know, you shouldn't make it slices just a clock. May I make it the stopwatch? It should be relevant for the user and its current context and its current situation. And it should be modular. Pay attention to that, because we'll come back to that later on. Slices may mutate. Where are slices used? Google search, soon. Trademark by a Blizzard company. Google Assistant soon, not yet. It's coming. But maybe you're up. You're free to implement a slices host. So if you can imagine a nice application, you may be like the first app that uses slices in the App Store. Well, they're not Google. Where are slices supported? I'm not sure if I mentioned it, but they came with 100p. So in 100p, they're baked into the system. We're not going to use that anyway, because we have learned that things that come baked into the system, well, they don't age that well. 100p, aka 109, aka APA 28, just to be everyone on the same page, many aliases. But you can use them in API more, starting at API 19, thanks to the, Jetpack, sorry. So how do slices work? It's way more simpler than widgets. There is a provider app and a host app. The host app takes the slice manager, requests the slice from the slice provider sends the slice view. That's it. Well, there's way more things going in the background. Actually, it's implemented with the content providers. Good thing is, yeah, they have to come back today. Good thing is, you won't see them for most of it, especially in the base cases. So how are the slices built? Let's get our hands dirty. So you require to have migrated to 100x or Jetpack or I don't remember the name. I don't really love the names. But you require 100x because we're gonna even consider like the platform version because we have learned our lesson. Target SDK version 28, that makes sense, I guess, and a couple of libraries just for support, so that's specific. You are encouraged to use that little thing left that's not really that descriptive. It's the Slice Viewer application, which Google provides. It's just a generic slice host where you can test your slices. We will make use of it later on. Quite discouraged is that to implement your Slice View API on your own, you can go, well, you could do it, by why? Unless you want a really cool meeting post, but why? So going back to the slide provider, it's just a super fancy content provider. So I mentioned content providers before, but worry not, you are not gonna be thrown into that massive and horrendous API. You're gonna be handling this one byte slice, I give you a URI, it's still a content provider, you get sliced back or not. Easy. Building the slice may look like that. It's a builder, a role builder, and a title. What about some nice DSLs? Yeah, much better. So there are some nice DSLs, here it's way more clear. We take a context, we build a list, we take it to infinity. No, that's actually because slices have a TTL, time to live, so they can expire. But here we're letting it stay. Single row, set the title, because I have no imagination. Remember, content provider, export your content provider, go to manifest, slash it in. The authority you provide there is important because you will access it by the, it will be part of the URI. Just run your slices. How does that slice look like? Well, we still have to think about permissions, right? It's not like you can just show stuff from any other application, like, no problem. Like, maybe launchers are automatically granted for widgets. That's not nice. So, permissions are automatically provided once you touch. But there's user interaction, so they are not, unless, I think you can do it for certain cases in Google Search, but You'll get presented with a permission request, and you will just see as an user this question. The slide viewer sample is my app, and slice sample, it's a bit confusing. I should have chosen a better naming. But the better thing is like, this is not my code. I didn't code it. It's a part of the support library. No permission checking code, no if API 20 something, whatever. And this is a slice. Beautiful, I know. What did you expect? You saw the code. It's a row, title. I think we can do better. So I thought, what can I build that is like kind of like I can get it related to Skyscanner and maybe get a presentation from it. So I built this, which is like, well, maybe be inspired. We'll have a section in the app, which is like inspiration. Maybe cheap summer breaks to Greece, Thailand, or Iceland. So this is composed from different, it's a list with different rows. First row is a title row we saw before with subtitle. Then the second row is a grid row. And then each cell contains title, image, subtitle. You can build that. But there is a problem here we are not seeing yet. What happens if we rotate the device? This is Android, guys. We rotate devices. There's so much more. Why was that hidden? Well, slices can scroll vertically if you don't tell them not to, but they cannot really scroll on sides. All that content will be lost because the slice is adapting to the width of my screen, the current width of the screen. Worry not, there is a solution for that. Just take a set, see more cell, and just add some text or something. Problem solved. stay hydrated, kids. Slices have sizes. I said it right. Size may affect your content. That's it, the gist of it. And actually, there are three standard sizes where your slices can be displayed. You can have shortcut, small, or large. So this is actually large. But it's large, and it's showing it all. But if my slice will be too large, even like the large will be cut. That's why we specify content and not really specific UI, not a relative layout or anything. We specify content, and then the slice code really decides what's going on. What happens if this same one, we put it in small? We lose this, the rest of the lines. We just have the main row. Which still like can have some actions on it. What happens if we set to shortcut? It's just an icon, like you will have a launcher icon or something like that. And all of this is great, but you may be thinking, well, we saw some Androids because you were too lazy to download the images. But I checked the documentation and they had a really nice looking slice. Is that even possible? Demo time. So let's go, demo bots, be with me. And let's go to the demo. If I can find it, yeah. Okay, can you see my screen? Should I increase the size? Good? Okay, so this is what I showed you before. The inspiration slice, I didn't really know how to call it. It's a list, nice DSL builders. I got a header, title, subtitle, grid row, cells, bunch of cells, because I wanted to show the see more. Images, text, and stuff. For instance, the images are icon compact, so that's one of the things, but don't worry, like there are nice helpers you can create from resources. I use the launcher icon because it's very lazy. But what? Let's build that one, right? So I've got it here for reference. Well, that's my copy paste. Where's my file? No. Whatever. I'll try to remember. You can help me. So let's add another path to your right. Like, I don't know, laundry. When it's laundry in the path. Of course, that method doesn't exist. So as I said before, just need a method that creates if you a slice or not. We're gonna use the list builder, like here. Actually, I'm just gonna copy it because I'm lazy, as I said before. So we have an empty list, not really inspiring. So let's add a header. So, what was like? What did it look like? Let's check. I come in trip to Seattle. So, say, upcoming meetup founder. And let's see if I'm able to put this in an emulator. Is it actually running? Run out. what's not with me. Oh, it's running. Good. So this is the app, but we're not really interested in the app. Remember, this is just content provided. So we're gonna go to the app, don't care. Go into the slides view. Here, this slides viewer, it's made so you input the URI of the resource you wanna show. This is because in slices are totally static. You need to know your URI. I cannot be up whatever and say, I'm gonna show all your slices in your device. There's no discoverability. Luckily enough, I know my URI. And there is upcoming meetup longer, just what I wrote. So it works. This is slice viewer, we can go into detail more than we have the full screen. Let's keep doing it. So what's the other part? June guests. So title is 26. 75 guests. How would you build this? Oh, we have a couple of actions here. So let's go and build those actions. I'm gonna do some copy paste because I need a pending intent for the actions. But it's gonna be totally fake. And the action is really boring to type, so I'm just gonna skip you from that. We're gonna save you. So I'm gonna add an action. This slice action. So let's go. What's going on here? Slice action has a pending intent, so you can have something to open. It has an icon and an action title.
The wrong method is to be in the left for a
file. Oops, thank you. Thank you very much. You saved me from looking stupid. Longer. There you go. Pending intent, icon, and action. This is like, this is an icon, location, check address, because I don't know, I imagine that's what people say. Can I run it now? Will it run? Yeah. Size example, we don't want this. Why? Yeah, here it is. Little action. We can create the other action, similar fashion. Copy pasting, and let's do message hooks. Yeah, we'll trust that work. So we get our actions, or we will get our actions. Let's get the image. What's that image? Well, actually, I figure out this actually is a grid row with just one cell. And the cell just has one image, which is an icon compact, one resource, and I happen to have a global combo laundry. I need to say how big it is. It's going to be a large image. I mean, it looks pretty large to me. Whoops. Okay. Let's check that. Example, I want you by. That's it. Not done yet. One more thing. There's text in the bottom. So what do you think that could be?
We draw with two cells.
Two cells, right? Good job. You're gonna be here. Actually, everyone is here. We draw. So. So, they have different names. Check in, check out. Check in, what time were you here?
Six.
Oh, actually, I did it the wrong way. Nine, maybe? It's been even more lazy. I can retain it. It's under D, guys and girls. It's under D. There was a little icon. I missed it. Wait. Yeah, you see it? It's under D. It rotates. Even more. Gonna make it small. So that has the actions. I'll make it a shortcut. You don't longer it. It's all here. Little recap. Slices are better than remote views. Probably only Google will use it for now, but you're welcome to try it. And cutting DSLs are really cool. Some resources, this is mostly for the online slides, but you can read them really quick if you want, if you know how to read Google links. I'll leave those in the slides, basically developer docs, code labs, and really helpful Nobola labs on slices, which actually went before they were public, so they are really interesting. Because they just dive really deep in the API. Thank you very much. At the end. Pizza?
Yes.
Pizza should be arriving right now.
So you can catch me for questions later, or you might need to hand in the copy to re-encourage.
A few things before we finish and start our social afterwards. So, firstly, there's a competition. So, are we going to announce a prize now? Yeah? So, if you've been tweeting at Android or the hashtag Android, then you may have a chance to win the Android things. Francesco, so, when are we kicked out here?
Is it around 9 o'clock?
So after pizza and beer here, there is a pub down around the corner called the College Arms. So if you still want to carry on trying to people to get kicked out of beer,
I think it's time because we need to tidy up and chicken.
And obviously, an absolute massive thanks to Skyscanner for hosting us here and providing an awesome speaker. And thanks to. And thank you to Fergus and Guillermo for giving these awesome talks. And thanks to all the people from Nevada who have actually helped organize it all and are doing all the stuff in the background and running to get more beer. And of course, thanks to everyone here for coming as well. We'd be lovely to refer to everyone. So, clap for yourself.
We got a winner. I know the winner. It's Andre. Andre is in the
here.
Where's Andre?